Myself, Dr. K. Viswanath, Allamraju, professor in Mechanical Department of Mechanical Engineering at Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Dundigal, Hyderabad. Today I'm going to discuss about introduction of clutches. This is part of Dynamics of Machinery course, unit number 2. Let us begin. What are the clutches? What are the functions of clutches? What are the principles under which it will work on, it will function? So a clutch is a machine member. A clutch is a machine member used to connect the driving shaft to a driven shaft so that the driven shaft may be started or stopped without stopping the driving shaft. A clutch thus provides an interruptible connection between two rotating shafts. Suppose here there is driving shaft and driven shaft. Driving shaft and it is the driven shaft. These two things, clutch thus provides an interruptible connection between two rotating shafts. That is, the two rotating shafts are driving shaft and driven shaft. So here a popularly known application of clutch is in automotive vehicles, especially four-stroke engines and four-wheelers and heavy vehicles. So here where it will be used, it is the connection between an engine and the gearbox. So what are the functions of clutch? There are five functions. Number one, to connect and disconnect the shafts. Number two, to start or stop a machine without starting and stopping the prime mover. Number three, to maintain constant speed, torque and power. Number four, to reduce the shocks transmitted between machine shafts. And number five, for automatic disconnect, quick start and stop. So here, what are the principles? Before going to understand the clutches, not only clutches, brakes and dynamometers, we have to understand the basics of engineering mechanics, which is so important to understand complete dynamics of machines. So let us begin. What are here? Equilibrium equations. There are three equilibrium equations. That is sigma fx equal to 0, sigma fy equal to 0, and sigma m equal to 0. This sigma fx equal to 0 means whenever there is some inclined forces acting on certain component or body, we have to resolve it into horizontal component f cos theta and vertical component f sin theta. It is for the single force. There are number of forces acting on your body like f1, f2, f3 and f4. At that case, particular case, we have to go for the sigma fx equal to 0 and sigma fy equal to 0. And this is for the algebraic sum of moment equal to 0. So here, if you want to further understanding of dynamics of machinery, the principles of friction is so important. So what are the principles of friction? Here, mu coefficient of friction, mu equal to F by R. What is F? F is the frictional force, and whereas R is the normal reaction. This coefficient of friction, very important role in order to study the clutches and brakes. So here, what are the principles of operation of clutch? When two friction surfaces are brought in connect with each other and pressed, they are united due to the friction between them. And the friction between two surfaces depends upon the area of the surfaces, pressure applied upon them, and coefficient of friction of the surface materials. And number three, the most important is the two surfaces can be separated and brought into contact when required. One surface is considered as a driving member and another one as a driven member. So here, further, what are the principles of operation of the clutch? When two friction surfaces, the driving member is kept rotating. When the driven member is brought in contact to the driving member, it also starts rotating. We can understand in detail in classification of the clutches and how the function of the clutches. The required qualities of a good friction material. So the required qualities of a good friction materials, what are the required qualities are required? Number one, a high and uniform coefficient of friction. Number two, the ability to withstand high temperatures together with good heat conductivity. Number three, good resilience. Number four, high resistance to wear and scoring. Number five, resistance against environmental conditions such as moisture, salt water or fungi. Adequate mechanical and thermal strength. These are the required qualities of a good friction material. So, what are the commonly used friction materials if you want to know? The commonly used friction materials are wood, cork, leather, asbestos-based friction materials and powdered metal friction materials. So, if you want to know classification of the clutches, there are different classifications are there. These clutches are broadly classified into three categories. Number one, based on the friction and based on the geometry. So, and based on the whether it is hydraulic or pneumatically operated. So, if you know it, so there are three types. Number one, jaw clutches and friction clutches and hydraulic clutches. So, you will understand more detail. This plate clutches, clone clutches, centrifugal clutches and single plate and multi plate. These are the five clutches are covered in today's session. So these five clutches are based completely on principle of friction. Let us start with friction clutches. The friction clutches work on the fact that friction is caused when rotating discs come into contact with each other. And these principles of friction clutches, very important to understand this. There are two shafts here and two discs. The shafts are, A is the shaft and B is the shaft. A shaft is connected with the C shaft and B shaft is connected with the D shaft. When this A shaft is rotating with certain speed, that is N RPM. So here, if we applied some force, axial force W on the disc and pressed against the C shaft, which is already in rotating condition, then what happens? The D disc also starts rotating with the equal speed of disc C. Here, what is matter? Here, equal speed, the speed of disc C equal to speed of disc D comes based on the coefficient of friction mu. If the friction is high, it will rotate the equal speed. If there is a sliding takes place, there is no equal rotation speed. It will not be equal. So this is what the function principle of the working of the friction clutches. So this is the description clearly mentioned in this slide. But the speed of D depends upon the friction force present, and which is in turn is proportional to the W force applied. So here, how to find out torque? The torque T equal to mu times WR, where mu is the coefficient of friction and W is the axial force, axial load applied, and R is the effective mean radius of friction surface. Then the friction torque T equal to mu times WR. So here, what are the dry friction clutches? There are different types of dry friction clutches as we have already studied. That is single plate clutch, multi plate clutch, cone clutch and semi-centrifugal clutch, and also centrifugal clutch. But we are going to cover, I am going to cover these three clutches, that is single plate, multi plate and cone clutches and centrifugal clutch. So what is the function of single plate clutch? Single plate clutch having is only single plate, that is a friction plate. This is the single plate is there here. This is the single plate. The single plate is in between disc driven disc and friction planes. Here there are different parts it consists of, how it will function. This is the engine shaft and the transmission shaft, and here pressure plate, pressure spring, clutch plate. So when we are starting engaging, means when we are going to change the gear, what we have to do, we have to disengage the clutch, then change the gear, then we have to engage the clutch, then only the engine, the speed between engine shaft and driving shaft and driving shaft, it takes place. Here if we go for next slide, these are the design details, how to calculate again friction torque. There are based on two functions it will work on that. Here how to calculate the torque, number based on uniform pressure and uniform wear. Here this is the P is the normal pressure is acting, the R1 is the radius from center line to outer surface, R2 is the radius. Here this is the friction surfaces. Normal force is acting W, this is the normal force is acting. So here normal force is acting, this is a single plate, this is a single plate clutch, that's why single disc. This normal force transmits from, this friction force transmits from R2 to R1. So here how to calculate the friction torque and what are the formulae, if you see it, then what happens, based on uniform wear and uniform pressure, by considering the uniform pressure and uniform wear, torque equal to 2 times 2 by 3 mu w R1 cube minus R2 cube by R1 square minus R2 square. And based on the uniform wear theory, and torque equal to, that is mu times W into R1 plus R2. Here when to use uniform pressure theory and when to use uniform wear theory, the main description is that here uniform pressure theory can be used for new bearings to calculate the frictional torque, and uniform wear theory can be used for old bearings for calculating friction torque. Here if the clutch plates has two friction surfaces, it should be, torque should be multiplied by 2. If the clutch plates having single surface, no need to, this two factor will not come into the picture. Here next, if you want to know multi-plate clutch, this multiple plate clutch or multi-plate clutch, very simple. Whereas in single plate clutch it is a single plate, whereas in multiple plate clutch there are multi plates will be there, but the number of friction surfaces are, it depends upon the plates. Suppose there are three plates are here, three plates are consists of two friction lining surfaces, total six surfaces are there. So what is the difference between multi plate and single plate clutch? We can understand the single, in multi plate clutch there are friction grip is very high compared to single plate clutch. What are the friction torque in multi plate clutch? So here this multi plate clutch especially used for heavy vehicles compared to single plate clutch. So this is the figure shows single plate clutch, single plate disc. So this is the working of single plate clutch. So advantages of single plate clutch, what are the advantages? With single plate clutch, gear changing is easier than with the cone clutch. because the pedal movement is less in this case and more reliable compared to multi-plate clutch. And what are the disadvantages, sir? Disadvantages are that as compared to cone clutch, springs have to be more stiff, and this means greater force is required to be applied by driver while disengaging. So next, coming to the, so far you have studied under the category of friction clutches, single plate clutch, multi plate clutch. The third one is cone clutch. Here there are two types of cones will be there. One is male cone, another one is female cone. So here female cone in the shape of the inclined surface will be there. This part is a female cone and here it is a male cone. In between, the friction liner will be there. So same here, the driving shaft and the driven shaft will be engaged with the help of the cone surfaced geometry of the clutch, but which is being operated by springs. The disadvantage of this clutch is that more force is required to engage the clutch compared to single plate clutch. So here, these are the three-dimensional view of the cone clutch. So there are, based on the colors we have mentioned here, cones female is the green one and male is the blue one, and shaft male cone is sliding on splines, friction material. This is the friction material. This friction liner is completely with the surface with certain thickness on the circumference of the cone. So how to calculate the friction torque? Based on the fundamentals of engineering mechanics, here also we are applying here, axial force is applied. Axial force is applied here, and the inclination of the cone is alpha, that is semi-apex angle of the cone, and the driving shaft and the friction lining. The friction lining is very important material. It is the very important for proper engaging and disengaging of, by engaging between driving member and the driven member. So in cone clutch, what is the total friction torque? That is T equal to mu times WR. And by considering the uniform pressure theory and uniform wear theory, what we have studied in before multi-plate clutch, for uniform pressure theory will be applied for new clutches, and uniform wear theory can be applied for old clutches. So here in the total friction torque, T equal to mu WR, and that mu WR R is the mean radius, that R mean radius equal to, that is the 2/3 times R1 cube minus R2 cube by R1 square minus R2 square cosecant alpha. By using for uniform wear theory, that mean radius equal to R1 plus R2 by 2 cosec alpha. So what are the advantages? The main advantage of cone clutch is that the normal force acting on contact surface in this case is larger than axial force as compared to single plate clutch, in which the normal force acting on contact surface is equal to the axial force. And disadvantages are, this type of clutch is practically obsolete of following reasons. What are they? Number one is that if the angle of cone is made less than about 20 degree, it will be difficult to disengage the clutch. This 20 degree, when it will be reduced to 20 degree, because of the wear and tear, it will be reduced less than 20 degree. So if it is less than 20 degree, it cannot be engaged, very difficult to disengage the clutch. And a small amount of wear on the clutch surface, on cone surface results in considerable amount of axial movement of the male cone, for which it will be difficult to allow. Thank you.